Hi everyone. We're going to be talking about firefighter reasoning questions today. If you are an aspiring firefighter who is looking to pass your next firefighter aptitude test, this YouTube channel is for you. Go and grab a pen and paper. We're going to be talking about five different types of spatial reasoning questions, and we're going to discuss what they are. What they're asking you to do, why they're important to firefighting, and how you can solve them. My name is Luann. I own Smart Tutoring and Test Preparation Services, and I am a Firefighter Aptitude Test Preparation Tutor. Let's talk about spatial reasoning questions. Spatial reasoning questions assess a firefighter candidate's ability to understand the arrangement of their surroundings and how they relate to them. So these are environmental questions in the sense that they want to know whether or not you can move through a building without seeing anything in that building and have no problems doing that. Spatial reasoning is one of those skills that enables you to do that. On the job, spatial reasoning skills enable a firefighter to remain safe, effectively use their tools, and work efficiently. There are five different types of spatial reasoning questions that you could come across in a number of different types of firefighter aptitude tests. These questions include reading maps, orienting shapes, reading tables, reading charts and graphs, and reading gauges. A probable spatial relation question that you will likely see on a firefighter aptitude test is a map reading question. These questions will ask you to orient yourself to the shape and layout of a given map. You could be asked to determine the direction in relation to your surroundings. You could be asked to follow directions to a specific location, or you could be asked to identify an efficient or the fastest route. Map reading skills enable firefighters to do their job efficiently. Firefighters use a variety of maps on the job. You might see a firefighter using a city map to get to a call or reviewing a floor plan before entering a building, for example. Here's an example of a map reading question. You can tell that this is a map reading question because you're provided with a map and the question is asking you to do something with it. In this case, you are to follow a set of instructions or a set of directions and determine the one-way street that you will reach after you follow those directions. Next, we have orienting shape questions. Orienting shape questions assess your ability to orient shapes to their environment. You could see questions with nets, or you could see questions with cubes, for example. Another type of question you could be asked is to orient different parts of a machine to one another. Orienting shape skills enable firefighters to orient themselves to their surroundings. They use these skills to judge distance and space. Here's an example of an orienting shape question. In this case, you're asked, when the net is folded, which three-dimensional figure will it create? Another spatial relation question we see on firefighter aptitude tests is the table reading question. Now, tables present data, which is facts and statistics, in columns and rows. So when you see information organized in columns and rows, you're looking at a table. Reading tables questions assess your ability to identify data. So you'll be asked to look at a table and pull out information. They could also ask you to compare the relationship between the data. So look at information in the table and draw a conclusion using that information. Here we have an example of a table reading question. We can tell it's a table reading question because the information presented is in columns and rows. In this case, we're looking at information on the top five highest paying cities for firefighter jobs in Ontario. Now we need to use this information to answer the question below. The question reads, what is the average hourly wage for firefighters in Ontario? scenario. So in order to solve this question, we have to look at the hourly wages and determine what the average hourly wage is in order to get your answer. Another spatial relation question you could see on the firefighter aptitude test is the reading charts and graphs style questions. Charts and graphs are both ways to visually display data, but they differ in how they organize and present information. Charts organize and compare data for detailed analysis. So, for example, if you're looking at a chart, you could be looking at a table, a diagram, a picture, a bar chart, a pie chart, or a map. On the other hand, graphs show trends over time and complex relationships. You're working with a graph if you're looking at a point graph, a line graph, or mathematical functions on a graph. Reading charts and graph questions assess your ability to identify data, or you could be asked to compare the relationship between data. Just like table questions, answers to chart and graph questions are in the chart and graphs, so you can use that information to determine what the answer is on your firefighter test. Here's an example of a graph question. We can see that it's a graph question because the information is presented in a pie chart. The question is asking us which type of call below accounted for the most fire calls. So, in order to determine the answer, we would have to look at the pie chart and determine the highest percentage of fire calls and then identify the type of call that is in that percentage. The final type of spatial relation questions I have for you is the reading gauges style question. Gauges are used to measure pressure, speed, RPM, and fluid level. You might want to make a note of that in your notes if you are working on pressure, speed, RPM, and fluid level. These are all measured with gauges. Now, in the workplace, firefighters need to know how to read gauges to do their jobs safely and effectively. In order to answer gauge reading questions, use approximation to assist you in answering the questions that you're being asked. Here's an example of a gauge reading question. The question asks, what does the speedometer read? So in this case, we need to know what a speedometer is, and then we need to know how to read it. We're going to draw that information out of the image, and then we're going to determine the answer that's provided below. If you have any questions about spatial reasoning questions, you can find me online at smarttutoring.ca. In terms of your next steps, if you are on the firefighter mailing list, you can go ahead and answer the spatial reasoning questions I sent you. This is a tutorial that was meant for you before you answer your questions. So hopefully you've gained some insight in terms of how to identify a spatial reasoning question and how to go about answering them. If you are not on the firefighter mailing list and you would like to receive free firefighter test questions and help on answering them from me, you can subscribe to the firefighter mailing list. It's free to do. In order to do that, you can go to the About section in this YouTube channel, or you can go to smarttutoring.ca/firefighter-aptitude-test-pdf. The link is there as well. Click the link and put in your information to subscribe. When you do that, you're going to receive a free firefighter practice test from me, and this is a valuable resource. So there's 60 questions that assess everything from your oral comprehension to your reading ability, your writing ability, your mathematical ability, your mechanical and your spatial reasoning ability, as well as your human relations skills. So 60 questions for free once you sign up to the firefighter firefighter mailing list. And then every Monday after you sign up, you will receive five additional firefighter test questions from me, just like the spatial relation questions we just covered, to help you move forward in your firefighter aptitude test preparation. My name is Luann. I own Smart Tutoring and Test Preparation Services. Thank you and have a smart day.